Hi, this video is from Indeed.com. Indeed.com is a job portal. In this video, I'm going to talk about lazy annotation. Explain lazy annotation in Spring Framework. Lazy in Spring can be used with configuration. The bean which has been declared lazy annotation will not be initialized by the Spring container. At lazy will be initialized by the container only when that bean will be accessed somewhere in the code. So that means on demand the bean will be created. I want to repeat, lazy annotation means on demand a particular bean will be created by the Spring container. Okay, so let me show you the configuration file so that you can understand. I have two beans, class A and class B. Okay, there are two beans available, and in the lazy app config file, it's a configuration file. It is similar to the XML file prior to Spring 3. So I have marked this as configuration, and two beans I have, and in one of the bean I have marked it as lazy. That means class A, this bean will not be created by the Spring framework when the context is created, when the first time context is loaded, when this configuration file is parsed and the beans are created. This particular bean will not be created because we have marked it as lazy. Okay, so this is not going to get created. So whenever we access this bean, at that point of time Spring framework is going to create this bean. So when I load this, when I start the application, only this bean will be created, not the class A one. So class A, class B, just a constructor I have just to show you. Whenever I start this application, I want to show you which constructor is called. Okay, so let me run this program in a debug mode so that you can understand. So here I am having annotation config application context. So here it will be loading the context. That means it'll read the configuration file, it'll try to initiate all the beans. If you see here, class B is initialized. That means this particular line of code has been executed. That's why we are getting this constructor call. Okay, but whereas class A, we didn't get any printout, okay, print statements, because class A it's not yet still initialized because we have marked it as lazy. Okay, now the moment I access it'll try to create. Can you see here, class A constructor is now, it is calling, the Spring framework is calling the class A now on demand, it is calling. Okay, so class A is initialized on demand, or lazy initialization I would say. So this is the purpose of lazy annotation in Spring framework. So you have to give value true in the brackets. Hope this video is useful. Thank you and all the best.